I love a good mystery, and while there is no shortage of mysteries under the microscope, some of them come from unexpected places. In this episode of Microscope World, I will explore the mystery of a very unusual observation I recently made, and it may leave us with a few more questions than answers. I've always liked Cosmarium. Its simplicity and symmetry has always intrigued me. In fact, the entire group of single-celled algae known as the Desmids have a wonderful array of shapes and symmetries. But I was especially interested one day when I zoomed in on this particular specimen and saw a mystery beyond its appearance. What is it that is moving around inside of this organism? My first thought was that this must be bacteria, but my second thought was that it couldn't be, because it appears that this organism is still alive and intact. I put the thought aside, but later I saw the same movement in another specimen, and so I decided to dig a little deeper. And it didn't take long to find out some very interesting things. But to explain properly, let me give you a little background on the Desmids themselves, because their biology, even if we don't understand it yet, is part of it. The taxonomic supergroup Archaeoplastida contains the modern plants, the embryophytes, and their relatives, including the red algae, the chlorophytes, a group of green algae, and a second group of green algae known as the charophytes, indicated by the red box. The charophytes are the closest ancestors to the modern plants, and it contains the single-celled charophytes known as the Desmids. Examples of the Desmids include Starostrum, Spirogyra, Zygnema, Microsterius, Cosmarium, and Clostrium. Going back to the Cosmarium individual we were looking at before, I still haven't answered the question about what is moving inside the cell, but digging a little deeper unearthed a lot of things about Desmids that are very interesting, including the unusual vibrating cytoplasm. As far back as 1884, Fisher examined the material vibrating in various species of Clostrium and determined that it was calcium sulfate crystals, and that the motion is Brownian motion. Brownian motion is defined as the random motion of particles suspended in a fluid resulting from their collision with the fast-moving molecules in fluid. It gets its name from the botanist Robert Brown, who first described the phenomenon in 1827. And so, one mystery is resolved. The motion in Cosmarium is due to crystals knocking around against each other due to the molecular motion. But it turns out that Fisher wasn't completely correct. A paper in 1980 by Fotheringham, Bradley, and Jenkins confirmed what others had suspected, that the crystals were not calcium sulfate, but instead are crystals of barium sulfate. This doesn't answer the question about why they do this, but there are some speculations. Barium sulfate is a dense molecule, and one of the hypotheses regarding the barium sulfate crystals is that it might act as a statolith. A statolith is a particle like calcium sulfate or barium sulfate that is used by some invertebrates that stimulate sensory receptors in response to gravity. Unfortunately, we don't have a concrete answer as to what the crystals are really for. What's more is that these crystals will form even in low environmental barium sulfate concentrations, although there is a positive relationship between the concentration and the number of crystals present. So what about the other Desmids? Spirogyra is reported to also concentrate barium sulfate, but it is more dispersed throughout the cytoplasm, and it is hard to see the movement. But the genus Clostrium and Microsterius are other examples where the crystals are visible. In Clostrium, the crystals are found in small vacuoles at the edges of the organism. So I recently found a specimen of Clostrium in a pond sample, and I had to look. Look at that. There they are. A small, dense troop of crystals, to be sure, but no less spectacular. Research has shown that Clostrium can also concentrate strontium crystals in addition to barium. Why that is the case is a complete mystery, but it brings up an interesting possibility of radiation bioremediation. Whatever the reason is for this unusual collection of crystals within the bounds of the cell, you can't deny its beauty. Ultimately, this is what draws me to the microscope. There are always so many wonderful mysteries in a world beneath our feet, yet seldom explored. Any given day, a random observation can send you down the rabbit hole of knowledge, and when you come up for air, an afternoon is gone, but your world is broadened. I hope you have enjoyed this episode of Microscopic World, and I look forward to going down the rabbit hole again with you soon.